Okay. So I would struggle with stopping. Inside, outside edge. Okay.
One way.
Yeah, exactly. So what I would try to get you to do is work on each edge. So what I would do is make an imaginary line at the top of a circle, pylon, pylon, move imaginary line into the far end. Is a way to set it up. Same thing, 5-6 lines depending if you're sharing ice. So the very first thing if you want is you work the inside edge. You make them stop in one direction. So if I might be stopping this direction, say I come to the blue line, they start in the great set position, they skate to the blue line, boom, stop inside edge. Adjust, get ready again, and as soon as the whistle goes, those kids move, the next 5 kids move. So then, before you know it, every single kid's moving down the ice. And you're working each line inside edge, okay? So then when you come back, you're working the other inside edge. Then it's the outside edge that the kids are gonna struggle with. So what's gonna happen if I come to that red line? Get them to come in slow, put their weight on this leg first, and then just kind of transfer it. Tell them like they're sliding into a baseball bag or trying to, you know, slide into that, because they'll try to go onto their toe, their heel, or if they're on rollerblades, they do a sharp turn and they bite it. But getting onto that outside edge is not the easiest thing. So just think, so I find if you go here, or here, and adjust, you can adjust from that. If you have your weight here and then you go back, sometimes that's easier. So I kind of try to slow it down for kids that way. It's different if you already know how to do it. You come here, boom, you're here, you know, I can adjust from there. Okay, so again, it's working each edge. So if you guys want, we can go down and try the outside edge. I think everything's gonna be excellent on the inside, but it's the outside edge I'd like you guys to try. And the other thing too is take your time and just try this. So it's just that weight transfer here, the slide in, just till you get the hang of it. And you got it, then a little lower, more knee bend, and then hammer it. Okay, let's go back down. Okay, so what happens after you do the inside edge back, up, opposite leg, then it's outside edge, opposite leg, then you put it all together and then it's a 2-foot stop. So it progresses all together, okay? Because what's going to happen, you're going to have a lot of kids, when you go to the 2-foot stop, no matter what, they're going to go like this, and you're dragging that. You see it all the time, they don't use that outside edge. But if all of a sudden you're going to throw across from the start, and go back the other direction because of transition, the puck went that way. Now they're adjusting going rather than being able to get across the target and slow it off that side. Okay? So let's just work on the outside edge real quick. We use top of circle, blue, red, blue, top of circle. So the first 4 are gonna go, okay, on the whistle. And you're gonna stop facing off from your left leg, pick your right leg up so you're coming. And then adjust.
Transfer that weight back.
different to really touch the whole thing. Again, if you really want to avoid that, you want to start on this one, and you're dragging that. One head.
You can start at the outside edge with the little guys, like, great from initiation on.
I think they all do it. But it took time, but you got to start somewhere. Again, you got to get the shot. What I find with some of the kids is just simple things of being stationary. You say, okay, just step over. Step over so they feel comfortable. Step over. Then the crossovers become easier because you're actually going to step up, crossover. And that's just a simple station that you can do. Keep in mind, all the kids actually have to step over one. Step over. And before you know it, when you get into crossovers, they already know that they can step over that foot. Okay? So just simple little things like that, those two things. So then we can get into backwards stride, which would be the same thing. Rod, do you have a felt on you right now? No? I left mine in the room.
Anyway. Sit
in. There you go, coach.
I can't skate, but I still got a good mark.
So, when we get into that backward stride, what would happen is if I just made a bottom line, well, then you think it's a seat gun, but actually, it's not half. It's not half hard. So,
better than your felt, right?
Anyway, with this, when we get into that backward stride, it's the same thing, alternating C cut, so if it's here, again, if I do just a C cut, I don't want my heel going behind, and I don't want my power to go all the way to here. Again, I'm looking right about here for that power, so if I do that half hard, I reach out and back in. Back. So again, it's heel coming back to the middle of the room to the heel. It's not going past it, that's where you start missing it. Because you're throwing too much behind. And you'll see a lot of kids in elbows. And that's because you're making big C cuts where your heel's coming behind your body. And again, we ask for full extension for recovery. As they get older and we're going full speed, you can't get it. But we try to get to our best of our ability. Because when you get high speed and you do a little backwards, sometimes you're not going to come right back. Because you see even the top, you know, you start out that way, but then right away, you see that. You're not doing crossover numbers, you're playing one on one. Okay? So again, it's a half hard cast. So again, it's here, it's up, heel back. So it's here, back. So that's what we're looking for when we do that. So backwards, we're going to go right leg only, all the way down. One hand on the step. Okay, first four, seated position, ready, set position, and go. Right leg only. Good, go back.
Thank you.
recovery. So do the opposite lane this time.
That's the other side.
Up just to focus then just on their legs for the more advanced, like the older kids?
Yes.
Just
because the thing is now you got to work on keeping your upper body and your core in a good position. So if I'm here, it doesn't matter if I'm going forward, I got to stay nice and tall here. I can't start breaking out the waist because before you know it, I'm on the toes. Okay, so then you can work your boundaries and work your knees and work on the stride. Just one thing, upper body. As you get going here, you know, your arms, not a whole lot of movement going on. You see, you don't have to. You take a look at the best guys in drivers, they want to have that hand to get going. It's either sitting on the body, don't get those arms going too much. Your legs, your lower part of your body is doing all the work. And you're going to have a lot of parents that have seen it or done free hand here. Doesn't do anything. Whenever you think it, that's for balance, that's the way you can add or come to stands and other that. I want to make sure you stick. You know, being here, if anything, any ground, just here, I'm doing something else. We got to get our kids knowing that our hands are here to make things happen here. You don't have to. This doesn't do anything for your balance. This does stuff for your balance, but this doesn't do anything. So, just something to we can get everybody on the same page on that. It's easier for the kids when they want to see. So, any questions on that? Okay, so then you can try to maybe get into some transition skating for the kids. So, depending on your age group, same thing. You can have an imaginary line, red line, blue line, imaginary line, or use the plexiglass. So, in between this pane of glass, that's my job. So my job is to transition right there. Because what happens is you're going to get a lot of kids that transition. And when I use one from forward to back, I'm going over here. Transition. Four, and now they're over here. straight, tight lines, given that gap and that ability to control. So, this, I'm finding this great. You can take advantage of this. So, I have to stay. Because you have that reflection, right? So that is one thing that you can work, and you can swing back far enough for a little bit. Get too close. So that's one thing. When you're teaching the transition, try to teach them that one cross. Don't let them do 3-4 because it gets them further away. So if you teach them, again, light and slow, extend that and then it's a step forward. So you guys might come natural. A lot of coaches will put a pylon down just to get them to go around it, but that creates a bad position for the hips. So all of a sudden, if you're telling them to go around that, turn my back in place. So if anything, you can still use that pylon, but go up to it. It's here. You know what I mean? You can do it that way rather than making them go all the way around and turning their body around. Okay, because now they're just more or less jumping to 2 feet. Where I want to go from forward to backward, but still have that speed going back. So again, if I was to go slow motion, it's coming up. It's extending out, stepping over, outside edge, back. So if you guys want real quick, kind of spread out here, just try and square, you've got to get on this edge, you've got to push off. This leg has to be back. If you you do it straight leg, that's where you get the little step over and across.
So when you make that turn, your heel is going across your toe?
Well, if I go to this side, go to the transition, see, I open up from this here, and now I'm taking off.
It looks like you're coming back.
Yeah.
As opposed to parallel.
Yeah, I'm extending, so I'm here. When I do a little bit faster, it's definitely a bit. When I go slower, I'm trying to go slower again, but again, I'm not trying to turn my body this way. Because if I'm playing him, I'm still going to stay square this way. So that's the thing about the transition part of it, right? And then if I go too many, and I play him, I'm wrong. So he has that lane, again, we're just trying to tighten things up. So, just a simple thing like that. Okay? And then from transition, the drill that really works well is, like I said, imaginary line, blue line, red line, blue line, imaginary line. What you do is you just get up to the blue line, transition, get them to transition so they're facing that direction all the time. Because when they come back, they're going to work the other side, right? So, they come up. See, I hit the blue line, transition, get them to open up so they go that direction too. So, then you get everybody going in the same direction. No one's gliding into each other. So, boom. That means if I transition right away, I'm going to transition so I go that way. And when I open up, I'm going to open up on that side. And then you have everybody, and you know what? Kids, the little ones are going to mess it up. No matter. But at least if you kind of get them in some type of order, it's a little bit easier. Okay? But if you only have half ice, you can do the same thing. You can put extra cones out because they're so young. You can put here at the hash, the top, and blue, and another one. So you got lots of these. So any questions on that, guys? I know it's a lot to take in, but we're trying to have everything on this one. If you have any questions, interrupt me, I'm fine with that. Not a problem. Okay? So then from there, guys, from transitioning, we can get into tight turns. With the tight turns, you can same thing. You can do about 8 pylons in a row. And all we're looking for on the tight turn, get their stick up. If you're young, you don't have to. But with this, we want to teach them how to lean out of this turn. So they go completely around that club. So when they go, they're here. So we don't want them dipping in. We want them to pull out. We want to keep that upper body out. Because what happens, a lot of kids start leaning in too much, lose an edge, fall down. Make sure our feet, their separation, don't have them so close together. So if I go into that, my lead leg, which is my left, pull it out, cross over, and explode. You're going to get somebody here that wants to get their feet together. So again, get them to stretch that out, okay? And make sure they get a crossover in at the end so they can explode to get to the next pylon. But again, it's that upper body. Make sure their upper body leans out, but it's turning in the direction that you're going, and so is your head. Some of the kids will do that. People with lifts will be looking at you over here. So again, if I'm going that way, I'm here. I'm in that position, I'm taking off. Okay? Any questions on that? You guys like to try that real quick? So what we can do is just top of the circle, blue line, red line, blue line, top of the circle, and we'll turn to our left just to find that. Still, just give me a pointer. So now we're over to the other side. Okay, other side. So leading up. Come on.
Thank you.
those kind of things. With the website now, you can go online and take a look at all that stuff. You can go on YouTube. And again, I know a lot of you have young kids. Just to start them off, like I told you, you can get them going on the step overs. And then right away, if you want to help them on circle work, just get them comfortable right now just to go. And even if you have some straight legs, that's fine. But if they get going, ask them to bend. If you have the older kids, then you can progress it differently where stick up on the shoulders. First thing is, outside, bounce, then right away, progress, we go from an inside C cut to an undercut. So it looked like this. And I want to come through and you want to make sure when you get to crossover, you get two pushes, either inside edge or outside. Okay, then you put it together. So really, my feet are coming up nice in this. Still trying to keep that upper body out, leaning out. But again, for the little kids, just get them to step over for now and get them comfortable that way. Then you can advance it from there. And then just stick on the ice and let them go from there. But again, if you see, when you do that inside edge to an undercut, you can see that leg come through. And what you'll see with the kids, if you, as they get older, you'll see it. So we do a crossover, but we got nothing with this. But if you're going to go through, you can actually get that second push coming through on the outside edge. Okay, you guys want to try that real quick? I would just like you guys, and you can keep the stick on the ice if you like. I want to see you do the inside to undercut, inside edge. Right? So keep the stick on the edge, and just go see both. Move.
Oh, you're done.
Oh, is it really?